हेलो फ्रेंड्स, मैं सेल्फ सुभाष नागर से फ्रॉम श्री दिगंबर जैन गुरुकुल हाई स्कूल सोलापुर। आई शैल वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन दिस सेशन ऑफ 9th स्टैंडर्ड मैथमेटिक्स पार्ट 2। द टॉपिक इज क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स पार्ट 6। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस विद प्रॉब्लम्स फ्रॉम द प्रैक्टिस सेट 5.3। फ्रेंड्स, इन द प्रीवियस सेशन ऑफ दिस क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स पार्ट 5 वी हैव बीन डिस्कस्ड with the following important subtopics, that is theorems from this chapter, and those were diagonals of a rectangle are congruent, diagonals of a square are congruent, and diagonals of a rhombus are perpendicular bisector of each other. Today in this session we are going to discuss with the problems that are based on the above theorems, means practice set 5.3. Friends, before going to discuss with the practice at 5.3, let us see the properties of rectangle, rhombus and square. And those are: diagonals of a rectangle are congruent, diagonals of square are congruent, diagonals of rhombus are perpendicular bisector of each other, diagonals of a rhombus bisect the pairs of opposite angles, diagonals of square are perpendicular bisector of each other, then diagonals of a square bisect opposite angles. Let us use these properties to solve the problems from the practice set 5.3. Let us start with this practice set 5.3. Problem number 1. Diagonals of a rectangle ABCD intersect at point O. If AC is at centimeter, then find BO. And if angle CAD is equal to 35 degree, then find ACB. You could see in the adjoining figure, ABCD, diagonal AC and BD are given, and this intersecting point is O. So let us start to solve this. This angle CAD is given 35. So here we have to find out first segment BO and angle ACB. Friends, quadrilateral ABCD is a rectangle given AC is equal to 8 cm, equation 1 given. Here this BD and AC are the diagonals of a rectangle which are congruent. Therefore, BD will be getting 8 cm since AC is given 8 cm from 1. We know BO is equal to half of BD since the diagonals of a rectangle bisect each other. Therefore, BO is equal to half into 8, 4 cm. So, we will get BO is equal to 4 cm. Also, here side AD and side BC are parallel and this AC is transversal. Opposite sides of a rectangle are parallel. So, angle ACB is congruent with angle CAD. Alternate angles, but CAD is 35. Therefore, you are getting that ACB is equal to 35 degree. So, you can write angle ACB is equal to 35. I think you understood this one. Let us see the next problem. The rhombus PQRS, it is given in the adjoining. PQ is 7.5 cm, then find QR. If angle QPS, this is the 75, then find the measures of angle PQR, this one, and angle SRQ, this angle. So, we have to find out here first segment QR, then angle PQR and angle SRQ. Friends, we know that here quadrilateral PQRS is a rhombus, it is given, but PQ is equal to 7.5 cm, equation 1, this also given. Therefore, QR is equal to PQ, these are the sides of the rhombus which are congruent, but as PQ is 7.5, so from 1 we can write QR is equal to 7.5 cm, that is our expected answer. Now, second we will find this one. Angle QPS is 75, it is given. Angle QPS plus angle PQR is equal to 180. Adjacent angles of a rhombus are supplementary. Accordingly, angle this P and this Q are supplementary. But it is given QPS 75. 75 plus angle PQR is equal to 180. Therefore, angle PQR is equal to 180 minus 75. Therefore, you can write angle PQR is equal to 105. Third, angle SRQ is equal to angle QPS. These are the opposite angles, SRQ and this QPS, opposite angles. Therefore, those are congruent. Therefore, angle SRQ is equal to 75 since this QPS is given 75 from 2. Therefore, we will get that angle SRQ is equal to 75 degree. I think this also you got. Now, let us see the next problem number 3. Diagonals of a square IJKL intersect at point M. Find the measures of angle IMJ, angle JIK, angle LJK. Friends, you could see in the adjoining figure that IJKL is a square and this IK and JL are the diagonals. Friends, what we have to find out here? First is angle IMJ, angle JIK and angle LJK. Let us start. Friends, it is given that this quadrilateral IJKL is a square. It is given. Therefore, segment IK and segment JL are perpendicular bisectors of each other. It is the property, diagonal property of the square. Therefore, you can get that angle IMJ is equal to 90 degree. I, here it is M and J, which is 90 degree. Angle IJL is equal to 90, angle of a square. Angle JIL is 90. Friends, angle JIK, this angle is half of angle JIL, diagonal of a square bisect the opposite angles. But this JIL is 90, therefore angle JIK is equal to half into 90. Half into 90, here you can divide and you will get that angle JIK is equal to 45 degree. Now third, angle IJK is equal to 90, angle IJK, this is 90, angle of the square. But angle LJK, this angle will be half of this IJK, diagonal property of the square. Therefore, we will get LJK is equal to half into 90. Therefore, we will get that angle LJK is equal to 45 degree. Friends, let us see the fourth problem. Diagonals of a rhombus are 20 cm and 21 cm respectively. Then find the sides of the rhombus and its perimeter. It is ABCD is a rhombus given. All sides are congruent. AC and BD are the diagonals. We have to find out side of a rhombus, perimeter of the rhombus. We will see that given quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus given. AC is equal to 20 cm and BD is equal to 21 cm. It is also given. Here AO is equal to half of AC, diagonal of a rhombus bisect each other, or those are the perpendicular bisector of each other, we could say. So you will get AO is equal to half of 20, that is 20 upon 2 cm. BO is equal to half of BD, diagonal of a rhombus bisect. Therefore, you will get BO is equal to half into 21, that is 21 upon 2 cm. This is the second equation. Consider this triangle ABO, this one. It is extracted and drawn over here. In this triangle AOB, angle AOB is 90. Since diagonals of rhombus are perpendicular bisector of each other. Therefore, here we will use the Pythagoras theorem and write AB square. This AB square hypotenuse is equal to AO square plus BO square. We calculate the value of AOB. We will substitute here. AB square is equal to 20 upon 2 bracket raised to square plus BO is 21 upon 2 bracket raised to square from 1 and 2. Therefore, AB square will be the square of this 20 upon 2 is 400 upon 4 and 21 upon 2 is 441 upon 4. Therefore, we will get AB square is equal to the addition of these two. Since denominator 4 is common, we will write here 400 plus 441. Therefore, we will get AB square is equal to 841 upon 4. Now, we will take the square root on both sides. Therefore, we are getting AB is equal to square root of 841 is 29 and 4 is 2. So, AB we are getting 29 upon 2. Therefore, you could write AB is equal to 14.5 cm. So, friends, the side of the and perimeter of the rhombus, we have to calculate rather than here, side is 14.5 cm. Now, perimeter, which will be equal to quadrilateral ABCD, perimeter of this quadrilateral ABCD is equal to 4 into AB. It is a formula. Therefore, perimeter of this quadrilateral ABCD is equal to 4 into 14.5, that is 58 cm. Therefore, perimeter of quadrilateral ABCD is 58 cm. So, friends, we will see the next problem number 4. state with reason whether the following statements are true or false. This is problem number 5. Number 1, every parallelogram is a rhombus. This is false. Since all the sides of a rhombus are congruent, while the opposite sides of a parallelogram are congruent. Second one, every rhombus is a rectangle. Friends, it is also false since all the angles of a rectangle are congruent, while the opposite angles of a rhombus are congruent. Now, every rectangle is a parallelogram. This is true. The opposite sides of a parallelogram are parallel and congruent. Also, its opposite angles are congruent. The opposite sides of rectangle are also parallel and congruent. Also, its opposite angles are congruent. Therefore, rectangle is a parallelogram is true. Every square is a rectangle. This is also true. The opposite sides of a rectangle are parallel and congruent. Also, all the angles are congruent. Here, for the square also, opposite sides are parallel and congruent. Also, all its angles are congruent. Every square is a rhombus. True. All the sides of a rhombus are congruent. Also, its diagonals are perpendicular bisector of each other. Here, all the sides of a square are congruent. Also, its diagonals are perpendicular bisector of each other. Sixth one, every parallelogram is a rectangle. It is false. Since all the angles of a rectangle are congruent, while the opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent. Therefore, this statement is false. So, friends, what we have been discussed today in this session is properties of rectangle, rhombus and square, problems based on the properties of the rectangle, rhombus and square, problems based on practice set 5.3. Friends, will you try these problems? Number 1, diagonals of a rectangle ABCD. Intersect at point O. If AC is equal to 8.4 cm, then find BO. And if angle CAD is equal to 42, then find angle ACB. Second, in a rhombus PQRS, if QR is equal to 6.8 cm, then find PQ. If QPS is 72 degree, then find the measures of angle PQR and angle SRQ. Diagonals of a rhombus are 18 cm and 24 cm. Respectfully, then find the sides of the rhombus and its perimeter. Diagonals of a square ABCD intersect at point M. Find the measures of angle AMB, angle BAC and angle DAC. So friends, try these problems. Certainly, you could solve them. You should not forget the famous words of Roger Bacon. Reasoning draws a conclusion, but does not make the conclusion certain unless the mind discovers it by the path of experience. Very nice wording. So friends, if you like this video, please subscribe and share with your friends, and don't forget to press the bell icon. So with these words, I would like to say thank you.